Introducing a new culture, Captain. Captain, the genetic sequence is still stored in the computer. If we need another sample, the replicator can generate it.
Good to know.
A weak greenish glow comes from this dish.
Green and glowing.
This colony of creatures appears viable for the long term. Quite vital and thriving.
And together, they'll have the energy to withstand whatever goes on with this machine.
I officially christen this life form, the Gammons.
Okay. He's into it now.
A weak greenish glow comes from this dish.
This colony of creatures.
I wonder if McCoy has anything to say.
These combined creatures have a triangular structure. These gammas have the energy efficiency of the omegans and the reproductive rate of the alphas.
Cool. Well, that is the gamma signal, isn't it? Symbol? Triangle-like?
No, I don't think that's necessary. No, I don't think that's necessary.
Try it out.
Well, Jim, it doesn't look like it does anything. Oh, I guess I spoke too soon. It took it in. It looks as if the colony is getting a foothold in there.
Life energy levels are spiking.
Yay.
They're building to a level sufficient for sending out a signal 100 times stronger than the one that brought us here, Captain.
The Gammon sample appears to be thriving in this environment.
Huh. They send a signal?
Thank you for your hard work. You have fulfilled the design for which we were created. I am authorized to tell you. Thank you for your hard work. You have fulfilled the design for which we were created. I am authorized to tell you.
It would appear there is more to this message than we are receiving.
Captain, maybe this is connected to that sensor we saw that was out of alignment.
A safe assumption, Mr. Johns.
Kirk to Uhura. Are you receiving any strange subspace or radio signals?
Captain, there is a neutrino-based transmission being broadcast near your current position from a point of unknown origin, probably from another star system. Our equipment is not designed to handle it. Though given 1 to 2 weeks, we might be able to identify patterns and extrapolate what it's trying to say.
We'll work on the problem from here. Kirk out.
1 or 2 weeks, huh?
Beautiful and quite lifelike, the three-dimensional projection appears to be a blend of Alphan and Omegan traits.
This projection is being cycled at 1,000 frames a second.
Same.
Thank you for your hard work. You have fulfilled.
Whatever he is, he's not alive. I get no readings at all from him.
Sound irritated by that.
I cannot affect this projection, Captain. Still, this is a very well done three-dimensional projection of a computer-generated form. The program and the equipment are very sophisticated.
We take pride in our workmanship.
Well, I got that through.
It seems to have the best points of both the Alphans and Omegans.
Whoa, my hand went right through it. It's a projection.
Whoa!
Our host looks like an amalgam of various races throughout the universe, especially the two we've seen depicted here.
Okay, let's go mess with those. Dish arrays? Different sound than before, or was it just the music?
Spock, see what you can do with this.
Captain, until power has been returned to these controls, there is nothing I can do.
Now,
this appears in pretty good shape for having been out for so long. I wish I knew how to use it.
I have an idea. We used the phaser before. What if we fire these rocks? Would cause the power to... Yeah, he's walking around doing stuff.
The energy level is insufficient, Captain. We cannot generate the energy level needed to provide geothermal energy with hand phasers.
If it's thermal energy you want, Jim, I remember this planet that used a starship's phasers on a microwave setting to heat the surrounding rock to provide temporary power.
An interesting observation, Doctor. We could use the same technique here, but the beam would have to be extremely precise. If we targeted the wrong section, we could melt the rock and destroy the array.
Huh. So, saving.
Save new game. Replace.
Does that mean we are supposed to contact the Enterprise to have them do it?
Mr. Scott requests to know if everything is all right, sir.
Tell Mr. Scott that everything is fine. Kirk out.
Okay, I guess we're just using phasers.
It is fascinating how desperate situations can inspire such illogical actions.
Jim, are you all right? It is fascinating how desperate... Jim, have you lost your mind?
It is fascinating how desperate...
Jim, this isn't funny. Jim, are you all right?
So, I can shoot these rocks, but if I shoot the others, I've lost my mind.
Jim, have you lost your mind?
Fascinating. I had not thought you... Captain, that action is irrational.
What the hell am I supposed to do?
Aside from this sensor array, there is nothing unexpected here. Fascinating how desperate situations can inspire such illogical actions.
Maybe on the...
Destroying the control mechanism is not in the best interests of this mission.
Need more hints here.
Captain, although this rock formation does indirectly lead to the thermal core, I suggest finding an area that would allow a more direct transfer of energy.
Where the hell would that be?
These rocks are approximately... Nothing unusual about that object, Captain.
Maybe I should mess with this one first? We should just have the Enterprise do it.
Captain, we are too far from the thermal core to sufficiently heat it. Captain, we are too far.
Jim, are you all right?
It is fascinating how desperate.
Oh, God, you people.
Jim, if you lost your mind.
Captain, we are too far.
Okay. Maybe we can only use one of them. Maybe it's this one. Hello. Let's try.
Jim, all you're doing is turning this rock plant.
Captain, that action is irrational.
Jim, all you're doing is... Jim, all you're doing... Jim, have you lost your mind?
Captain, I do not believe that will help our mission. This rock is a secondary formation produced by the interaction of plates, earthquakes, and volcanism.
Alright, I meant to hit.
This rock... The array appears to have deployed recently, which... Nothing unusual about that object, Captain. This rock is a secondary...
I'm confused.
I will need to adjust the controls before the sensor array is realigned. The array appears to have deployed recently, which explains... These rocks are approximately one... These rocks are appro... These rocks are appro... This appears to be similar to Federation technology, Captain. Its control principles are similar to the Madai sensor dish on Vulcan. It has locked the array at a 35-degree angle. Without knowledge of the code control sequence, I cannot adjust it. Nothing unusual about that object, Captain.
It's standing on a rock. You think that it would be...
Captain, although this rock formation does indirectly lead to the thermal core, I suggest finding an area that would allow a more direct transfer of energy.
Which is where?
These rocks are approximately... These rocks are approximately... Rocks are approximately...
How can we tell what goes to the thermal core?
Captain, although this rock formation does indirectly lead to the thermal core, I... These rocks are approximately...
Try it anyway, because... Not working out too well, is it? I really want to have the Enterprise do it.
Mr. Scott requests to know if everything is all right, sir.
Tell Mr. Scott that everything is fine. Kirk out.
No, blow the rocks, you stupid Enterprise. What the hell?
Nothing unusual about that object, Captain. Captain, although this rock formation does indirectly lead to the
Where?
Core, I suggest finding an area that would allow a more direct transfer of energy.
Right. Which is where?
Captain, although... This appears to be the most accessible spot to heat the rocks below the ground and generate geothermal energy for the array.
Yay! Okay. And I guess I'm firing and it doesn't work. It's not enough power. So let's contact the Enterprise.
Kirk to Enterprise. Sulu, can you read me?
Sulu here, Captain. How can I help you?
The Enterprise should broadcast a low-level microwave beam at the coordinates I am sending.
We have them, Mr. Spock. Get ready. Stand away from the blast area.
Stand by, ready for weapons position.
That would be a good idea. Standing away from blast area and all that.
Sending microwaves now.
I don't think that's far enough away. That is a very wide beam.
Temperature near the power coupling is rising rapidly. I estimate a below-ground temperature of 345 degrees Kelvin is required to reactivate the array. It is at 320, 330, 335, 340, 345, 350.
Shut off the beam, Mr. Sulu.
Affirmative, Captain.
Good thing Mr. Sulu is so good at what he does.
The array is now drawing power. We were successful.
Yay! Okay, so now we can activate device, or do stuff with device.
The control mechanism for the array. Unlike the rocks surrounding it...
The array is functioning stably. I estimate our discharge has given it adequate energy to function for 13 days, 7 hours, and 26.8 minutes.
Yeah, that 0.8 minute, though, is so important.
The array appears to have deployed recently.
Alright, is there anything else we need to do with this, Mr. Spock?
Captain, the parameters of this sensor have been preset. I suggest we do not change them unnecessarily.
Well, there's my answer. So this is power, and the other one changes the direction of the dish, I believe. I'm not sure what the last one is for.
I will need to adjust the control before the sensor array is realigned.
Okay. Then adjust.
Captain, these controls do not seem to be functioning properly. The array is a precision instrument that shows a high degree of machining.
Can the Enterprise help again?
Scotty, I need a calculation from the main computer.
Nice.
Well, I know the computers on the Enterprise aren't quite as good as our engines. I think she'll manage.
I'm sending the problem.
Ugh, that was too easy, Mr. Spock. The angle is 32.5 degrees.
Thank you, Mr. Scott.
So is there anything else you need, Captain?
Not now, Scotty. Kirk out.
I love Mr. Scott. Besides Spock, he's probably my favorite. Okay, so do we know what to do now?
I am now attempting to realign the device to 32.5 degrees.
Do or do not. There is no attempt.
It should now be correctly aligned.
Cool. Cool.
Interesting controls, right, Spock?
Fascinating, Captain.
Okay, do we have to do anything over here?
Let's see. Eeny, meeny, miny, moe.
Captain, perhaps you should not use the sensor controls.
Alright, Spock.
Captain, the parameters of this sensor have been preset. I suggest we do not change them unnecessarily.
Okay, so we don't need to do anything else then, I'm supposing. We go back from whence we came, and not that way. And see what this gamma being, quote unquote, is trying to tell us. Let me just look at this.
Captain, is that what hell's like?
Funny.
Nothing unusual about that object, Captain.
Nah, I mean, you see that every day.
No, I don't think that's necessary.
I don't understand any of this, Jim.
Any more hell stuff?
No effect.
Alright, let's go. Back to that north chamber. See if this thing's still hanging out here. Hello? Can you complete your message at this time?
Thank you, Captain, for your aid in constituting my people and in the unexpected necessary realignment of our communications array. You have performed admirably.
Thanks.
Of the 16 stations reporting at this point, there have been 50% fatalities, 30% other failures, and only 20% successes. One group got points for style.
Points for style?
Style?
Is this some sort of game? Not another alien race with a superiority complex. Who are you this time? Your appreciation is welcome, but many questions remain unanswered. Who are you? Points for your appreciation is welcome, but many questions remain unanswered. Who are you?
I am wondering about the style thing, but I don't think those are very diplomatic questions.
I am Sisissa. A projection of a synthesis of Osra and Visner. Clearly you know that the primitive life forms you have been dealing with are incapable of creating that in which you now stand. You will also note that the more demonic of the creatures displayed a passivity you did not expect.
True.
While the morally pure creature was aggressive and bloodthirsty.
The contradictions were noted and duly dealt with. I take it you were testing us on our ability to deal with disparate and contradictory inputs.
Yes, your reasoning ability was being tested, as well as your ability to adapt to new ideas when they conflict with deeply held beliefs and cultural customs. You passed quite admirably. The Brassica are impressed.
I'm not clear on who the Brassica are.
Captain, from this site, I can deduce various things about the Brassica. They are taller and more slender than we are. They are possessed of three fingers and a thumb on each hand. I suppose bilateral symmetry, and I know they possess greater visual acuity than humans.
Solarians?
They visited this place well before humans had left the Cro-Magnon stage of development. And I note they have avoided detection by us, and presumably every other race in the universe, before they decided to send out signals to bring us to their bases.
Thank you, Mr. Spock.
And more you shall know as you continue on the quest. I wish you luck.
They've already tested us.
Scotty, four to beam up.
We've already been tested. That message on the view screen after we finished that one mission. Second one, I believe.
Alpha and Omega. The beginning and the end.
In this case, Bones, a new beginning. We were the midwives for the rebirth of a life form. Two halves that have been made whole again. That's the way it was meant to be.
Let us hope that this is the end of Ensign John's prejudices.
We can all learn to stop judging people by appearances.
He's right here.
Ensign Johns might have done well to remember the biblical representation of Lucifer, appearing in the guise of an angel of light.
You can never trust anybody, and people who look like pointy-eared hobgoblins are definitely at the bottom of the list.
It appears that Dr. McCoy did not learn the lesson of this mission either. Unfortunate, but not unexpected.
Fortunately, the Alphans and the Omegans, learned philosophy and personal belief, are not as easily divorced from logic as some would believe. We humans attain our greatest fulfillment when both of them are united.
Really, Captain?
Really. But I've had enough philosophy for one day. I'd rather worry about these Brassica and their cosmic quest.
Well, with me aboard, we're sure to get points for style.
Many questions remain unanswered.
Very good.
And there's only one way to answer them.
Captain, message from Starfleet.
Bring it up, Lieutenant.
How do we get style?
I have a report from your recent assignment, Captain, and have a few comments.
Sounds
the
good.
The brass and Starfleet are impressed with the results of your recent performance.
Thanks.
Outstanding work, Jim.
Yay.
Keep up the good work. Kane out.
Ahead, Mr. Sulu. Warp Factor 5.
Leaving orbit. Increasing to Warp Factor 5.
Ah, I love his voice. Such classic characters. So we're going to have a preview of the next episode here. Before I sign off. Called Voids.
Spock, where do you think we should start looking for this Brassica?
Logic suggests that they will present us with opportunities to come to them.
Captain, a message from Starfleet.
On screen.
Captain, the USS Regulus has been forced to cancel its survey mission to the Antares Rift. We've decided to redirect the Enterprise to that mission. The USS Hood will take over for your current assignment.
Of course, the Antares Rift has a rather dangerous reputation.
Nothing the Enterprise can't handle. But be careful. Starfleet out.
Okay. So thanks for watching. Tune back in next time for Voids. Looking forward to having you guys join me. If you have any comments at all, or anything like that, please feel free to leave comments and likes and stuff like that. Don't ask for them, but at this point, I'm really not getting anything but a couple spam comments. So thanks for watching. See you next time, and endure. In enduring, grow strong.